COVID. Not really. I just yawned and something went down my throat. Can you tell that I try and muffle coughs by going with my mouth? Because if I really cough, if I have a cold, I'm usually like, ah! Of course, I don't want to be ill. The minute you get a cold, someone thinks you have corona, then you have to get tested. I am thanking the fucking Lord that I've not been ill this year. Touch wood, that doesn't happen, so. Just get me my vaccine and then everything will be okay. Hey guys, Stone Folks here, welcome back to another video. Today's video is not going to be very important, not going to be very intelligent, not going to be very interesting. That should be the intro for every other video, but no. So, once again, I was on the internet, click, 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 and I was having a look at cars on Motability. Also, I Relay UK text phone through to DWP today to ask about my PIP form. Apparently, they received my form January 26th, trying to remember. It was handed over to the decision-making team on the 1st of February. And it's still with them now. And to that, I hope they're going to be fair. And on whatever day, 2 weeks from now, I'll find out about my Universal Credit as well. Ah well. We'll have to see. Yeah, it's been a busy day. Not really, but yeah. As far as the click, 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 click researching on the internet goes, it was for my Motability car, if I can get one other. And I had a look. My first option that I thought of was after I drove the Sandero, was to get a Duster, because it's slightly bigger Sandero, and maybe more powerful. They look nicer, they are nicer, you know, better quality. Then I decided, nah, I won't do that. Then I saw the Jeep Renegade, and I went, oh, I'll get a Jeep Renegade. But I can only afford the lowest end model of it. The others are like 1600 and 1995, like 5 quid off 2 grand. I was like, uh-uh. Then I saw Audi Q2. And I thought, right, that's very nice. I was going to stick with that until today. Where yet again, I changed my mind twice. And of course, technically that doesn't mean I've made my mind up. But I had two ideas. One was a Mazda CX-30. Looks amazing from the outside. It looks amazing from the inside. But apparently it's not very spacey. And the one thing that put me off was the person who was making a video says something along the lines of, it doesn't feel like you're driving an SUV. You don't feel like you're very low off, like you don't feel like you're very high off the ground. But if that doesn't matter to you, then blah, blah. I was like, oh, Jesus. Well, yes, it does. Then I found the car that I'm after. MG ZS. I saw that car before, but I never thought twice about it. In hindsight, I believe I can afford the most expensive model of it. In saying that, there's only two. There's the Excite and the Exclusive. The Excite is a lower end model. It has a traditional key start, which I prefer, but it doesn't have some of the infotainment features and upgraded mirrors that close in when you lock the car and whatnot. The Exclusive has, I believe, a better interior, upgraded entertainment systems, better car locks. Like, obviously, you just walk away and it shuts, the mirrors go in. There was something else that he told me in the, there was something else in the video that I'd seen. Oh yeah, the wiper blades as well. It's like, if you go one click up, you get intermittent, the other one is just one wipe. Like what it is in my dad's car, I believe this anyway. But in the lower end model, it's one click up for one wipe, and then middle's off and down is intermittent or something. Basically, the upgraded version will have a lot of better stuff. And it's the cheapest upgrade I've seen. The lowest end model is zero upfront payment and total mobility allowance. The... I just totally brain farted there, sorry. The upgraded one is 299 up front and total mobility allowance. Considering the Audi that I was going to go for was like 600 up front, that's a pretty good saving to just go to an MG ZS. MGs are really good. And also, it's a bigger car than the Mazda, it's a bigger car than the Jeep, and I believe the Audi too. It's still counted as a small SUV, but it's not as small as your normal small SUV. I don't know. Hopefully, it's good. Oh, I'm so out of breath because I just flipped my mattress. I have two Super King mattresses on my bed and I flipped them both at the same time. I got leverage with my leg under both of them, lifted them right up, and flipped the top one over the bottom one. And then the top, well, the now top one went flat. I had to lift it up and reach for the end of the bottom one and then lift it back over and then flatten them and push them all back into place. In the backside. Well, at least I've not got metal bits digging into my back now. Or, well, I don't for a while. I will soon because they're all built like shit. As soon as I move house, I'll be able to get myself a new mattress. A memory foam one. Until then, though, this mattress is okay. Oh, it's better than the last one. Or the bottom one. Anyway. I need a drink. Have water. Oh. And that being said, that's the end of this vlog. So thanks for watching, like, subscribe, turn that notification bell if you haven't already. It's free! And I'll see you all in the next one.